talking about particles. Hey, nice to see you again. Welcome back. So I wanted to talk about making logos. So the benefit of making a logo in, say, something like Adobe Illustrator is that you create the artwork in vector format. So now you're able to resize it, make it as big as you want or as small as you want, and not lose any of the quality. Versus if you use something more like a Photoshop, if you draw it at a certain size and you stretch it out, it looks very pixelated and fuzzy. So that's why I use Illustrator. But the challenge is, what happens when someone wants some realistic looking flames? Or something that happened to me just a couple weeks ago, I was working on a logo and they wanted a lot of particles. And particles are tough to make look real in vector format. Until now. Let's take a look. Go to the computer. So first off, I wanted to show you guys the logo that I created. So if I zoom in, you'll see all these really cool looking particles. So real quick, let's take a look. This is a gradient that I created in Illustrator. I'm going to show you guys how to do this. They have a new gradient tool that I'll make another video on later. But for now, let's work on these particles. So what I'm going to do is get the pen tool. And this here is the fill and this is the stroke. I'm going to turn the fill off because we don't need the fill right now. And I'm going to create, say, an orange-ish color. And I'm going to create a nice stroke here. And this is the selection tool. If I click on the black arrow and I click something, it's going to select the entire thing. If I click the white one and click, now I'm able to just select parts of the shape that I'm dealing with. There we go. Something like that. Now I am going to click on the line and I'm going to come over here to where it says stroke. Here we go. Bring this up here so we can take a look. Okay, so I'm going to change the weight. I'm going to go down to about 0.5, and the caps, I'm going to do the round cap. Corner, I don't know if that really matters much, but right here where it says dash line, I'm going to click on that and I'm going to deselect so you can see what happens. So the dash itself is 12 pixels long. And then what you can do too is create a gap. So if I wanted the gap to be 6 pixels, I'm going to type in a 6. Oops, might help if I had the line selected. I'm going to type 6 and hit enter, and let's see how that affected it. You see how the gap became smaller? But what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the dash be about a 1, and the gap, let's just play around and make 2. So now we can take a look. You see how it looks a little bit more like dots? So what happens if we did 0.5, just for, here we go. Okay. So we have this line and it's a bunch of little polka dots. I'm gonna click Alt, click and drag to make a direct copy of that line. And then we're gonna come over here to this blend tool. Actually, I'm gonna hit the black arrow and select this one line. I'm gonna then go to the blend tool I'm going to click on this one node. And you see how that little white box there turns black when you're on the next node? I'm going to click on that. So what's happening is Illustrator is taking this line and blending it with the second line. And it created this one line in the middle. If I come here and I double click on the blend tool options, if you double click, the blend tool options will pop up. And right now we see that the spacing is set to smooth color. I'm going to click preview because it's nice to see what's about to happen. I'm actually going to change that to specified steps. And one is why there's only one line in between here. But if I do, say, 15, I'm just going to hit tab. You see how that many more lines are created. So for now, I'm just going to hit OK. I'm going to zoom out. I'm going to move this stroke. I'm going to get the white arrow tool or the direct select tool just because I want to be able to click this one anchor point and stretch it out. And you see how it affects the lines that are in between the two. So I'm going to drag this over here, get a nice dramatic curve going. It's almost like playing with calligraphy. Okay, so now that that's there, I'm going to get the selection tool just to be able to grab the entire thing. I'm going to move it a little bit closer to the middle. Zoom in a little bit, and this is where it gets really neat. I want to make sure that the appearance panel is open. I'm going to use the direct select tool and select the second line. I'm then going to go over here to where it says stroke. You could actually do it over here too. I'm going to double click on the little box for the stroke. I'm going to try to make that a little bit more red or a brighter orange, I guess, and hit OK. And just to see the full effect, I'm going to turn off the gradient. And that didn't really help either. I'm going to create a box with gray color. And this is just to be able to see what we're doing. I'm just going to real fast create that box and then zoom in. So now you can see the gradation going from the one stroke to the second stroke. So we're going from this orange to the yellow. But I want this to stand out just a little bit more, so I'm going to select the first stroke. I'm just going to go super bright, go all the way up to the yellow. There we go. And again, you can take this and move this around and make all kinds of really cool shapes. So let's do that same thing. Oh, you know what else before we go? I'm gonna click on this second line. I'm gonna go over here to where it says stroke. I'm gonna open up the stroke and hit opacity. So now I can actually take the opacity and drop it down. And you see how we can actually make it disappear into the gray. Now that we're here, we might as well turn on this on. I'm thinking if I take this and change the stroke color to, say, a white, that's really gonna make it stand out a little bit more. I'm gonna click this color and change that. That makes it disappear a little too much, but I think you get the gist of where I'm going with that. And again, if I come over here and click on opacity, I can turn down the opacity, or I can change the blending mode. And what that'll do is it'll create an effect on that line. And if we change the color of the background, it'll actually affect the way that that line looks. And that's with two paths. So now what I'm gonna do is lock that down, turn that off, create a new layer. What happens if we get a rectangle? Drop it down there. And again, if you look, since we created the dotted line on the last line that we created, that same thing is going to stay in the next shape that we create. So to affect that, we go back to the stroke and then we just turn off dashed lines, and then it's back to being a solid line. And I'm gonna go ahead and turn dashed lines back on. And something that I've been wanting to try, I'm gonna take this ellipse tool and click and drag, and I'm hitting the shift key and the alt key. So it shift will constrain the proportions to stay as a perfect circle. And with alt, it'll draw the circle from the middle. So alt and shift together constrain the circle to a perfect circle, and it's drawing from the middle. So I'm going to grab both of these shapes and I'm going to center them. So I'm going to go to the align panel, click on center vertically and center horizontally. And now I'm going to take that blend tool again. I'm going to click on one of the nodes from the square, and then click on one of them from the circle. And you see that shape that's happening there. I'm going to double click on that blend options. You can do specified distance too, but specified steps is the one that I found most, where I found most of my success. So I'm going to bump that up to 25. And there, we're starting to see really cool shapes. I can take that. I'm going to take the direct selection tool and take the circle and just really play with it a little bit. And you can see where some of these really cool shapes are starting to happen. And if you're wondering, I wonder if I can add more nodes to that shape, you sure can. Take the pen tool and just click on that path. You see that little plus sign that happens? Click on that path. And now with the direct select tool, I'm able to take that anchor point and move it down here, and the shapes update. And if you select the entire thing, you can come back here and you can actually turn that into, say, 1 point or 1 pixel dash and 3 pixel gap. I'm gonna play around with that a little bit more. I'm gonna come over here and turn this guy back on. And if you just sit here and play around with this, it actually becomes a really cool little Zen moment. So there you go. Particles in Illustrator. You have to be careful though, because the more particles you add, that's the more math that goes into creating all these curves and everything, and Illustrator will start to chug on your computer. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you know anyone that might learn something from this video, go ahead and share it with them and let them know that we're going to be here every week doing all this wonderful creative stuff. If you haven't yet, go ahead and subscribe. And there's a little bell right next to the subscribe button. Every time I come out with something, which is going to be every week, you'll be alerted if you click that little bell. Go ahead and do that. All the cool kids are doing it. All right. That's it for me. See you guys on the next one.